Hey guys, welcome to part 11 of my Let's Play of East Origins. In this part, we'll probably begin to once again climb the tower. As you can notice in the last few videos here, we've mostly just been going around doing things to finally that's the storyline. And now it's time to once again move on. This here is actually a really good spot if you're trying to find an experience. It's actually insanely good. So if you end up getting stuck here, all you have to do is just enter and re-enter the room and you're good to go. Kind of fortunate to know those rooms actually give you a bonus. Like plus stats, minus, depends on something like that. Didn't have to re-enter this room, I probably should just take a look and go on to the other side. You know, it almost seems like they kind of forced the Mask of Ice to to be in there. As usual, you really have to use it every time you play something in the entire game. Not that much of a purpose in this one. Now once again, I kind of forgot to re-equip the charms. Seem to have the habit of doing that. Honestly, I haven't noticed too much of a HP renovation happening, but I don't know if you get to the first thing. Experience it. And this is why you definitely check the levels. I just kept going around and minus this part. No, it was supposed to, like, in the Oath of Fel'Gonna that once you get, like, a complete stat sign, it does change your character's appearance. That's the default skin, but that's kind of boring for a while. You never would think that Sam would have the velocity of ice at any point. It's actually really interesting. You can actually fall for this room here and go down to the bottom part without any loading. Trying to go back up the cliff is really hard without the shield up. It's better taking the force shield skill up more. Now, I wonder if you can actually do this where you don't summon to the sun. Yeah, you gotta go to the fire launcher way back up. Those fireballs are useless against these guys. Come on, not so much. That's right here, also, it just leads to the back. only off chance you want to try climbing that hill. Go for it. Oh no. I don't know why I just didn't go into that room at the bottom at this point, because it fogged me off of the spikes 4 or 5 times now. Now I can finally run around without slow, but it's still making my life a ton easier. This is the room right here that I'm in. The RV mission for the next part. I literally grind her for a ton of speed very quickly. Usually the best way to tell if you're ever level at any point is the fact that that red bar still moves at a very fast pace. But if it's doing that, it's the less experience you gain. That's going to give you like at least 2 levels very quickly. And once you get past the threshold, the next experience, no experience once you need, it's such a high rate that you have to go to the next area or at least gain a level. Unless you're crazy and really inefficient with your time. Time to go fight this boss, and then maybe that's the next level. I kind of forgot to increase the power of the ropes I got, which is minorly important to do. For those wondering, I do have these videos recorded, and then I'm using a faster way to put my voice over it. They might notice the red boss push up the base of that tower. You can actually kill that, he stops attacking. which is probably why I should be taking off first, since it looks like I'll be trying to be dealing with this boss. Because you don't get this waves or anything. It's also one of the few bosses you can't really regain its health after a while. The issue isn't that the gaps are green, it's just that the stars glow. As you can see right there, so it's really slow. It can actually beam at this level, it's just that you have to kill that base first before you kill the stars, and that's what I wasn't doing. It took me 3 attempts to beat this boss before I finished it. And on the third attempt, I went and grinded for quite a long time to get through here. And of course, if you're over level for a boss, it becomes really, really easy. I should definitely be using Burst Salt more, as it has more damage to take, and also increasing the damage you do as well. So if you're not using it all the time, you're actually harming yourself in the end, or making it harder for you. Now there's also an X mode for doing Open Field Gone, but you don't get that too really late in the game. And actually, you do not know how you can achieve it. You could be doing something that involves maxing up the SP. I think the reason they made it much harder to get is because it has less amount of health, so that you can regenerate health during the boss fights. And that actually is fairly usable, because if you do a good enough job, you can get max health for the majority of the fight, and you don't have to worry about taking damage. He also up 32. Let me go back here in just a second. At this point, it becomes so much easier. I barely took any damage and do tons more. If anything, it shows you how level sensitive the game can be. last time I was probably dead at this point. Oh well. Didn't go down or go down. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.